moving on, guys. We're going to talk about what to actually plant. I'm going to cover springtime and frost seed. Chris is going to cover fall. You can tell whose handwriting is better. But starting right out in the spring, a lot of guys like to establish clovers, which can be great. When you're establishing a clover food plot in the spring, it's going to be a perennial, which grows back every year. And in the spring and summer, you're going to have to deal with some weeds. We had this issue this past year with Chris. So in this instance, before you plant your clovers, you're going to have to, you know, do a chemical burn down to get your clovers established in the majority of times, and you'll have to maintain those with some sprayings, you know, throughout the summer to get that clover food plot established. Can be done. We've done it before. A better option is to frost seed clovers into standing wheat and rye. So if you're planting your wheat and rye in the fall, you're going to let that establish, and in the spring, you know, say March, end of February, you can just frost seed clovers into that wheat and rye, let those clovers establish, and say whatever it is, June, mid-June, end of June, your wheat and rye is gonna start to fade out, your clover is established, you mow that wheat and rye, it kills it, and you're left with a beautiful clover plot. Now, we like to plant buckwheat. Very seldom do we plant clovers, but we do. We like to plant buckwheat, and the reason being is buckwheat is very good organic matter for the soil. It's easy to establish, loves heat, and it deals very tolerant to drought. It's high in moisture content. A lot of folks don't realize that deer actually get a lot of their water content from plants and not from drinking water. Deer can go days, weeks without drinking water. They get majority of their water through plants. Buckwheat, if you snap a stalk in half, it's literally shoots out water because it holds it in there. It's very high in moisture content. We like to till this back into the soil in the fall, create organic matter, helps build that soil, and it's very easy to establish. Typically around the 70-day mark, it starts to flower and deer will start to consume it. It's not really deer food. It is, but it's not. Sometimes they'll eat it, sometimes they won't, but we like to plant buckwheat. Another issue is I see on social media is a lot of guys like to plant soybeans. It can be done. Soybeans is probably the number one failure, huge failure with food plots, is because you can't plant enough to establish the deer herd, to sustain the deer herd. They just mow it to the ground. We did a test this year. We planted 3 acres of soybeans, and we ended up fencing them off with a dual perimeter electric fence for roughly 45 days. Took the fence down, and we had great soybeans all year long. We also incorporated sunflowers into that. Reason being is, I like bees. I like honeybees, so I like to see the bees in there. And sunflowers, you got that huge head on there, creates great green manure when you turn that back into the soil. Now, with all this, are clovers needed? Is buckwheat needed? Are soybeans needed? Are sunflowers needed? Who knows? I don't know your property. We don't know your property. We don't know what's around your property. These are just options to consider when planting. Consider if you have tons of ag, is your little quarter acre food plot really going to make a difference on your property if you're surrounded by tons of ag? Probably not. But if you're looking to plant these clovers for turkey hunting, it's a great idea. If you're looking to plant a quarter acre food plot to benefit a wild free ranging deer when they have hundreds of acres surrounded by ag, probably not your best bet. Let that go, and then Chris is going to touch on what to plant in the fall for you guys to have great deer hunting success.
Okay, what we like to do is there's a time frame. We're not going to tell you a specific date like throwing the bags do sometimes.
You go by temperature.
So you're looking at fall time. Sometime around late August, early September, we like to put it in there, and we like to use a mix that contains, not limited to, but contains a winter wheat, a winter rye, oats, and brassica, minimal usage. Reason being, the winter wheat, winter rye is gonna be very palatable for them. It's going to be the first thing it greens up in the spring when you start getting some of that sunshine down on your plots and it melts it off. And you those warm days, it germinates at a low temperature. So this is very good to sustain your plot. Oats is great. They like to come in and get that early on. But the problem with oats is it's only going to last till your first really hard frost comes. So that'll die out off on you. Brassicas, we like the Brassicas Limited. That pertains to turnips, kale, rape, radish, rutabagas, things like that. That's like a treat to them. Mm-hmm. And they're going to be digging for bulbs. You know, this time of year here, you know, we still have a good amount of snow on the ground. They're going to be digging for it. They like to get into there. Now, you can incorporate this time of year. You can put down clovers and alfalfas at this point in the year, and that'll establish it, and so that it'll be greened up for you in the spring also when the winter wheat and winter rye are greening. We like, don't forget, these are cereal rye and winter wheat. You got to remember that. There's a lot of these companies are selling you rye grass. Mm-hmm. I just had a guy email me the other day, said, look at these bags of throw and grow I have. I said, turn the bag over and look at the ingredients. And he was reading it, and the main ingredient was rye grass. And I said, dude, you got duped.
Yeah, it's very, very poor seed to plant.
So,
another tip on this is when Chris said, can't go by a date, go by. Plant 45 to 55 days before your average first frost, which is going to change, you know, from throughout the country. Our average first frost is maybe October 20th, October 30th, somewhere around there. So we're looking to plant somewhere within that time frame. You can even go up to 60 days. Just depends how mature you want your brassicas, if you're planting brassicas. But this right here is a very good time frame because your wheat and rye will be still in that tender stage. It'll be very palatable to the deer. A fail real quick is planting brassicas way too early.
Yeah.
There's guys that plant them back in July. They're so mature, by the time hunting season comes, they're not palatable anymore.
Now they tend to get thick and stalky and woody. It's just not something that they desire.
Yeah.